You know, the people that built down here were creative. The approach to things here was artistic, kind of radical, outside of the box. You could try things out here. The history of Venice is it was a free zone. It was a place people would go and let their hair down.
It was the land of the wanted and the unwanted. I mean, it was Hell's Angels and hippies and old beatniks, and it was just crazy down here. And this little tiny community was sort of overlooked.
For the longest time, Venice was kind of the dog neighborhood.
Venice was a hub for artists because you could rent space for a lot less than anywhere else in the Los Angeles area. And it's close to the beach.
So far as I know, I was the first movie person to kind of set up shop in Venice. I didn't want to be in Beverly Hills or Hollywood or Westwood. I wanted to be among the kind of people that I could relate to. It was much more of a communal experience to live in Venice, no matter what you did.
What was happening with Venice, it's like Soho in New York or something. The artists move in, you know, they start frequenting the bars and the restaurants, it attracts more people, and you know, it just sort of helps grow the thing.
Venice has always been a paradise for artists because of the beach and the bohemian lifestyle. It's a lot like New York. You can walk around and just see people on the street and see the same people every day.
You know, it's a great community and the people are looking out for each other. I think it's reminiscent of, you know, Greenwich Village, certainly, some years ago.
We walk everywhere in Venice. We're never in our car. You can get to the best restaurants. You can get to the beach. You can go people watching. Whatever it is, it's all right there in our neighborhood and we walk everywhere to it. That's just created like an amazing environment for my family.
When I graduated from college, I decided to come back to Los Angeles and I had tried different neighborhoods. And it wasn't until I decided, you know what, I'm gonna live in Venice, that I really felt like I found my home, because I feel like it just draws such an eclectic person.
There's just something inspiring about it, you know, from the sunsets to just, you know, the drum circle on Sunday nights down at the beach. You know, you get hundreds of people that are out there that are pounding on their bongos or whatever in unison, and it's one of those where you go, whoa, that's kind of cool and different.
I mean, to me, the boardwalk is Times Square. You know, it's where you get the full frontal view of Venice, you know. It's like when you go out in Venice on your bike or walking or whatever, you're gonna see something that you're not gonna see anywhere else in the city.
What really drew me to this place when I was older after college was I was here as a child and I felt so comfortable here and I loved the vibe. I felt like you could create anything or be anyone you wanted to be here. I just love the people, I love the atmosphere, and I love the creativity.